Operator, sound off for comm check.
Roger, operator. This is Dagger One. I read you loud and clear.
Good to hear from you, Dagger One. I assume you received the dossier for your target this evening?
Yes, I did. Although I'm surprised I had time to with the schedule you're running.
I apologize for the short notice. One of our intelligence providers came across the location of your target at a bar last night. A surprising amount of Throxheads inhabit the local tavern.
I bet.
All right, recap.
The target is one Anthony Jameson, also goes by Anthrax. He's a class 1 narcotic smuggler, although recently he's been dealing in Throxin vaccine like it was candy. Past reports indicate that the Throxin vaccine he traffics is subpar, and may be the same strain as the pandemic.
You did your homework, Dagger One.
What else am I gonna do when I'm sprung by a helicopter from the training range at 8 in the morning? Based on the flight, I'd say I'm a long ways from home.
That's affirmative, Dagger One. You are currently located 60 miles north-northwest of what used to be downtown Chicago.
That explains the contamination here.
Once you pass the river and floodplains, you can breathe easy. The Throxin's mostly in the water in this region.
Roger that.
Jameson's a paranoid by nature. He's going to have automated perimeter defenses around the compound, and at least one guard. Expect a mercenary or two indoors. Surveillance indicates that Jameson will most likely be in the basement. The informant says he's home for the evening, hence short notice for the op.
Just so you know, I had no time to switch rifles.
You're going out with the fluorescent barrel, aren't you?
There are worse situations. By the way, I loaded up on live rounds in the chopper.
You'd better hope his guards are colorblind.
I'll be fine. You just deal with the intelligence side of the equation.
Well, hopefully you're as good as the company says you are. Either way, when you're in there, keep an eye out for any written intel you can find. Tech is not important. Jameson's avoided the tech division for years with false trails and ghost programs. He's probably written all of his records and shipping manifests down in hard copy.
How do you want Jameson?
Target is listed as expendable. Kill him.
That's what I like to hear.
Client requires a proof of death token. Jameson is known to have a unique necklace on him. That'll work. Operator out.
Understood, operator. Dagger one out.
the outside of the compound and I wasn't able to find anything. Everything seems to be going, electric fences, motion sensors, everything's in place.
Got the phone. Go get some gear or whatever. Like, I gotta... These people are trying to figure out what we have. Hello? Yeah. You need to know how many cases we had?
Crowley, listen. Drek's in it deep. He's in trouble. I don't have the resources to help him. Not directly.
And I do?
Despite my best efforts? Yes. You do.
Caleb, this is highly irregular.
Crowley, Drek's been missing for 2 weeks. We were working salvage in Zone 12 south of Green Bay when we came across... Well, I don't know what it was. An anomaly. Anyway, I've learned some basics about the systems that initiated the anomaly. Most
located the catalyst for the transition.
Hold on, hold on. Caleb, a transition to where?
Into the lattice work.
What in the hell is the lattice?
Crowley, 10 seconds to transition. I have control of the initiating system, so I should be able to contact you when you're inside. There are some anomalies that may affect our communication between dimensions, so just be aware when...
What was that about dimensions?
Transition in 3 seconds. Good luck, Crowley.
Caleb? Caleb?
Come in.
Caleb, where the hell did you go?
Some dimensions seem to allow me to contact you through certain channels in the lattice work. There must be some variable that might...
Caleb, shut up. I was just attacked near the train bridge. It looked like the exact same bridge I crossed earlier.
It probably was.
How is that possible? I know we're talking about dimensions, but doesn't that still mean that I should be in the same spot when you transition me?
Not necessarily. When I run coordinates to account for your shape and position, there is an algorithm that helps relocate you on a vertical scale in order to account for changes.
What causes those changes?
Anything, really. In multiple dimensions, you are walking into places that have had entirely different histories. There are so many variables that factor into each dimension, and some match up almost perfectly, which lend to similar civilizations, landmarks, and cultures. But some evolve in entirely different ways, which leads to changes ranging anywhere from the extinction of species to continental drift. So compared to the last dimension you were in, you are in the same spot, but you are about 1 meter lower than you previously were.
I didn't feel the change.
That's because the algorithm acts as a negative relocation variable. It solves the change in terrain by solving the equations as if the Earth was moving up under your feet and was coming to you. The equation leaves a remainder while it calculates your elevation, and the remainder factors into the original algorithm, which moves your position throughout the lattice work.
Sounds complicated.
It really The scientists were terrible at taking notes, so I figured all of that out by myself.
Makes sense, I think.
I'm sending you to the next dimension. I'll see if I can't work out the communication algorithms while you're there. I'll set it so that you'll transition shortly after I make contact. If I make contact. And assuming Drek isn't there.
Good plan. How do I know there won't be hostiles in the next dimension?
You won't.
Lovely.
Remember, when you move from place to place, whatever you are touching, whatever your physical body has contact with, excluding the floor, things in your hands, within your grasp, that is what comes with you. If you are not attached to those things, they will be left in the dimension you previously were in. Transition in 10 seconds. If I were you, I'd keep that rifle of yours very close at hand.
Roger that.
Jameson, I killed you. I guess we'll have to get reacquainted.
King, fillet knife.
Crowley, I've learned how to access the communication system in different dimensions. Are you all right?
Get me out of here.
What? Oh my.
What did you say?
Get me out of here.
Working. Transition in 10 seconds. Transition in 5. 4.
Grabbing your gear, brother?
No thanks.
There's no need for that gas mask if you don't want to wear it. So, to answer your question, my name's Rothko. The K.
I'm Crowley. Who were those men?
Back at the road?
Yeah.
They were slavers.
Slavers? Where are we?
A few miles south of Caldemort Slave Fortress. Everything's to the north of here. is patrolled by slavers, while everything to the south is wilderness.
Wilderness? Just wilds?
Wilds. Very few people inhabit it. Very difficult to survive in.
Am I the only one you've ever helped here?
No. I actually have a system for getting people out.
So you've helped others?
You could say others helped me.
Anyone in particular?
His name was Slave 597. He devised a plan to get us out. Well, if it weren't for him, him and I could very well be slaves this day. He devised a plan to help us get out. Help me get out, help me sane. Help me from falling into the mindset of a slave.
Sounds like a hell of a guy.
Sure was.
Whatever happened to him?
Just vanished.
Just vanished?
Just looking at him like I am right you, and just disappeared.
Hmm. What was his name? Slave 597?
Well, after we escaped, he said to call him Drek.
Drek? Wait, you know him? Where is he now?
Last I saw him was 2 miles that way.
Back at Caldemort. Look, I know we just met, but if Drek was able to trust you, I can trust you. I'm gonna need your help getting back to Caldemort. Do you think you'd be able to help me?
No need for convincing here.
Sounds good.
How does it feel now to watch it burn?
Coast is clear, guys!
Okay.
Thank God, I know. It's all. Man.
It smells like cat poop down there.
It does, doesn't it?